This is high school basketball on Frontier Community Access Television.
Porter into Diaz. Lays it up and in. Porter, jump shot is good.
Porter.
Hook shot goes.
The left side to Diamond. Diamond spots up the three and hits it. It's past the Diaz.
Paint shot good. Ella gets the lane. Lays it up off the glass and in.
Nino runs the baseline. Reverse layup goes.
Hook shot off the glass and in. Lisa Portier, very aggressive. Skyhook.
Diaz.
Hook shot in the lane is good.
Portier
drives through, running. One hander off the glass and in.
Dean. 3-point lane.
She hits it.
Dean.
Hell of a three. Good.
Frontier Redhawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Tonight's game, the Frontier Lady Redhawks take on the Amherst Hurricanes at Gunnow Gymnasium. Once again, Chris Collins alongside with Alec Eckel, Kevin Murphy, and Zach Helk. As tonight, the now 1-2 Redhawks take on the 1-4 Hurricanes. The Redhawks coming off an 11-point loss to Turner's Falls the other night. A tough outing. They played tough defense, but offensively they just didn't quite have it together. Didn't quite have a consistent offensive set. That's something they'll have to have tonight against the Hurricanes team that comes in 1-4 but still dangerous. A relatively small squad, only 7 players on that roster. So Frontier may have a numbers advantage in terms of their depth. They can definitely switch lots of people in and out where the Amherst Hurricanes don't have that luxury. Should be a fun matchup for Friday night at Gunnow Gymnasium. The Frontier Redhawks and the Amherst Hurricanes independent high school basketball action. The ladies' side, coming up on Frontier Community Access Television.
Now for tonight's starting lineups. First for Amherst, at forward, number 13, Casey Baumgartner. At forward, number 15, Ingrid Salvador. At forward, number 24, Madison Lair. At guard, number 4, Eric McClain. And at guard, number 11, Carter Calsa. And this is coached by Dustin James. And now for Frontier, at forward, number 4, Lisa Portier. At forward, number 15, Sarah Munier. At center, number 21, Lexa Boyden. At guard, number 1, Marie Diamond. And at guard, number 23, Ella Dean. Frontier is coached by Mary Sanderson. The officials for tonight's game are Steve Kreitz and Scott Nikovic.
Well, very nicely done. A little problem with the sound system, so the folks here at Gunnow Gymnasium took care of the anthem on their own. That's something you don't see every day, but nice to see. So for the Redhawks, it'll be Marie Diamond, Lisa Portier, Sarah Munier, Lexa Boyden, and Ella Dean, the 5 on the floor, against Clays, Kalisa, Baumgartner, Salvador, and Lemire for the Amherst Hurricanes. Both teams getting a last-minute instructions from their coaching staff, so this should be very interesting to see how the Redhawks come out in this game and what kind of an offensive set they try to run. Felt to me like during that Turner's game, they were taking one too many passes and not enough shots. We'll see if they change the game plan against the Amherst Hurricanes. And again, Amherst comes in with only 7 players on their roster, so it's not exactly a deep bench. And the toss is up, but it's controlled by Frontier. Diamond now with the ball in the middle. Left side to Dean. Dean drives through, running one-hander in the lane is good. 2-0 Frontier, Ella Dean. Not wasting any time to get the Hawks on the board. Calsa now for the Hurricanes. Right side to Salvador. In the corner it goes to Baumgartner. Down the middle to Salvador. Salvador driving right side, dishes off to Calsa. Running jumper in the baseline is no good. Rebound pulled down by Frontier. Dean, right side to Diamond. Fakes the three, feeds the paint. And going up with a left-handed hook is Lexa Boyden. Count it in one. So a very different Frontier team to start this game than we saw against Turner's. Much more offensive minded. And Lexa draws the foul on Ingrid Salvador. Amherst can ill afford to get into foul trouble with their small numbers in terms of people on the roster. Boyden's free throw is good. That makes it 5-0. Kalsen now bringing it up for Amherst. Right side to Salvador. Salvador trying to drive on Munier. Spins away. Trying to get someone to pass to. Does kick it back out to Kalsen. Now to Salvador in the corner. Salvador now drives right side. Jumper on the baseline. Hits the side of the iron. No good. Rebound controlled by Diamond. Battle for it on the floor. Possession arrow goes to Amherst. Well, they're going to call it. There should be Amherst ball under the basket. Salvador to inbound for the Hurricanes. Ingrid throws it in to Lemire. And now back to Kelsa. Kelsa to Lemire, top of the key. Right side to Salvador. Salvador traveled. Good defense by Frontier to make her take the extra step. So we'll go back the other way. 6:38 to go first quarter, 5-0. Frontier with the lead. Dean now, right side to Portier. Portier back to Dean, top of the key. Dean over to Diamond. Diamond looking for someone to pass to. She gets it back out to Ella. Ella runs right side, bounce pass to Portier. Portier draws double coverage back to Dean. And Dean to Munier to Diamond. Deep three ball. Back of the iron, no good. Rebound pulled down by Clay's. A foul as Diamond ran into her as she made that that recovery of the ball. And so we're going back the other way. First foul on Diamond, team's first. Quick substitution as Taya Nolan's in the game for Amherst, replacing Baumgartner. Now Kelsa, right side, stops. Top of the key pass, knocked loose. Controlled by Clays. Clays, pull up jumper just inside the arc, misses badly, rebound. Pulled down by Diamond. Diamond tries for the cross pass, can't get it away. It's stolen back by Tayanoa. Now a three ball for Clay's no good. Rebound pulled down by Munier. Here come the Hawks. Munier to Dean. Dean right side to Diamond. Back to Dean. Dean to Diamond. To Portier on the baseline. Portier kicks it back out to Ella. Ella looking for someone to pass to. Bounce pass to Diamond. Diamond looking to feed the paint to Boyd. They get tied up. Possession arrow stays in Frontier. Only 11 seconds, though, on the shot clock. Diamond inbounding. Gets it in to Boyden. Boyden, turnaround, hook shot goes. So Alexa Boyden's got 5 of her team's 7 points. 7-0 run to start this game for Frontier. Kalsen now crosses the timeline. Runs it, and passes right side to Salvador. I think if Frontier scores in this next possession, I think Amherst might want to get a timeout. Salvador driving through, got knocked out of her hands. Will stay with the Hurricanes, again with 11 seconds left to go on the shot clock. Quick substitution, Kate Hickey's in. Helena Diaz is in. Diamond steps out. Boyden steps out, Munier steps out. Also into the game is Tori Speth. They throw it out deep. Clays with a deep three. Back iron no good. Ice cold right now with the Hurricanes. Rebound pulled down by Salvador. Ingrid got bumped. That's going to be a quick foul on Kate Hickey. Team second. 4:49 to go in the first quarter. Salvador to inbound. She does. To Nolan. Nolan tries to drive through, gets stripped of the ball. Ella Dean comes away with it. Dean kicks it left side to Hickey. Back to Dean. Right side to Portier. Portier up, fakes, traveled. Well defended by Taya Nolan on that one. So we'll come back the other way. We've almost got an entire half of a quarter without any scoring by Amherst. Very unusual to see. Kalsen now, right side to Lemire, back in the middle to Clays. Clays driving right side on Portier, spins away, running hook off the glass, and it goes. So Amherst is on the board, 7-2. Dean now with the ball. And it goes right side to Portier. Portier inside to Diaz. Diaz muscles her way through, lays it up, no good. Second shot, no good. She goes after it again. Tie up, possession arrow goes to Amherst, but again, Helena Diaz, very, very tough at the paint, got the height and tough to move around. That time she got a couple of whacks at it, just didn't quite get it to go. 4 minutes to go in the quarter, 7-2 Frontier. This is Salvador driving through. Pull-up jumper at the foul line is all net, so Casey's on the board. Quick 4-0 run for Amherst, they trail 7-4. Ella Dean driving through, running one-hander from front of the iron, no good. Amherst controls the rebound. Nolan pulls it down. And here come the Hurricanes. Salvador driving through, stops. Dishes over to Nolan. Nolan takes a shot, misses. Rebound controlled by Hickey. Over to Ella. Dean to Hickey. Hickey in the middle of Portier, and again, took an extra step. Coming back into the game is Marie Diamond. Stepping out is Lisa Portier. Salvador now with it. Top of the key. Runs left side. Hands it back off to Kelsa. Back to Salvador. Bounce pass in the paint. And it goes off the hands of Taya Nolan. And Frontier will get it back the other way. Dean. Bounce pass right side to Hickey. Hickey's pass stolen away by Salvador. Good handwork there. And she hands it off to Kelsa. Over to Salvador right side, and she took an extra, just dragged that foot just enough to take the extra step. And Frontier will bring it back the other way. They got to a quick 7-0 run, and they've been ice cold so far since then. In the corner it goes to Hickey. Over to Dean, back to, Ella Dean has it now from Diamond. Inside to Diaz, Lana drives through, shot up, no good, spun out. Battle for the rebound, controlled by Amherst. Now a tie-up is going in there after it was Hickey. And the possession arrow will go with the Hawks. Actually, that was Marie Diamond that did that and forced that turnover. Boyden back in, Diaz out. For the Hawks. They run out of the stack. And it's Hickey with it now, left side to Diamond. Diamond driving through, dishes it back out to Ella. Dean for three, it looked like it was way off the mark. And they're gonna say that the rebound was pulled down by Boyd, never hit the iron, but she stepped on the baseline. 2:07 to go in the quarter, 7-4 Frontier with the lead, but they have not had a bucket in about 4.5 minutes. Kelsa now, left side to Clays. Clays driving through, a hook shot, and she got bumped on the way up by Marie Diamond. And that's going to be two quick ones on Marie. Team's third, non-shooting. Ella Dean's going to take check out. They're going to leave Diamond in there, it looks like, with the two fouls. Salvador inbounds to Clays. Clays driving through, and again got blocked. And if that is on Diamond, that's going to be her third. Nope. They're going to give it to Kate Hickey. That's a break for Frontier because Diamond would have had to go to the bench, although that's two on Kate. So this one's going to be a shooting situation. Erin Clays. First shot is no good. She will get one more. They're going to get Diamond out of there. Ella Dean back in after a brief rest. Pretty good starting backcourt they have there, Diamond and Dean. And second shot is no good. And over the back foul, though, as Balkas smacked Alexa Boyden going for that ball. So Frontier will go back the other way. That'll be their second team foul. The first on Balkas. Ellen out. Right side to Hickey. Hickey to Portier. Diamond rather, back to Hickey. Quick shot by Boyden is no good. Rebound knocked around. Portier hits the ground. Possession arrow favors Amherst. A lot of tie-ups in this first quarter, but not a great deal of scoring. 7-4, we've been stuck on that for about a minute and a half, 2 minutes now. Kalsenow brings it up for Amherst. Looks like to Salvador. Salvador goes in the corner. Back out to the top of the key to Balkas. And a quick shot off the glass by Nolan is no good. Ella Dean the rebound. Right side to Diamond. Back to Dean. Left side to Hickey. To Portier. Portier drives through on the baseline. Couldn't make it go. Had a clean look at it, though. Just couldn't get it to drop. Less than a minute to go in the first quarter. Nolan. For someone to pass to. Crosses it down low to Balkas. Back to Baumgartner, a shot up and good. And that makes it a one-point Frontier lead. 7-6, 30 seconds to go in the quarter. Dean, ball stolen by Clays. Clays traveled. She lost control of it. Clays was thinking we're going to take the lead back, but didn't happen. Sarah Munier in, Marie Diamond out. 23 seconds left in the first quarter. Ella runs it left side. Dean to Hickey. Hickey runs it right side. Hickey bumped by Clays. And that's going to be a foul on Aaron. Third team foul. First on her. 9.7 ticks left. Frontier, shot clock is off. Dean. Jumper on the baseline is no good, way off. And they're just going to dribble it out. Oh, and nearly stolen away by Portier, and that's how we will end the first quarter. We played one quarter in Goodnow Gymnasium. On the scoreboard, it's the Frontier Redhawks 7, the Amherst Hurricanes 6. This is Redhawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Second quarter upcoming, the Frontier Redhawks with a 7-6 lead over the Amherst Hurricanes. Frontier started the game on a 7-0 run, and the Hurricanes were able to hit three field goals to make this a one-point game, but certainly a little more aggressive offensively than they were against Turner's, but the Hawks still having a tough time putting the ball in the hole as a number of looked like easy shots that just didn't fall. Once again, you can catch all of these games on our YouTube page, FCAT Media at YouTube.com. Also, if you're watching this on Frontier Community Access Television, you can catch these games on Channel 12 and Channel 15 in South Deerfield. Dean now, left side to Munier. Munier bounce pass in the right wing. Diaz just into the game, running hook shot, no good. Putback is no good. Frontier cannot get those second opportunities to go for whatever reason. Kalsen now with a chance for Amherst to take their first lead. Right side to Baumgartner, Salvador rather. Trying to feed the paint to Lemire. Ball hits the floor. And the tie-up, possession arrow favors Amherst. So the Hurricanes will keep it, but they only have 13 seconds on the shot clock. Diamond in, Hickey out. For Frontier. Kalsa inbounds. Travel. Yeah, you can see that happening. She just got hung up again. All you got to do is that little hesitation, and that's going to get travel pretty much every time, and that's what happened. Diamond now, running the point for Frontier. Drives through, gets a little bit daylight, gets fouled on the way up, so Marie Diamond will go to the line. Sometimes that's all it takes. If you see that seam, you just take that run and maybe you make the shot, maybe you don't, maybe you draw a foul. In this case, the second foul on Clay's, Amherst's team's fourth. First shot by Diamond is no good. She'll get one more. Diamond's second shot is good, so she makes one of two. Frontier leads 8-6. Kalsa bringing it up. Goes left side to Salvador. Salvador runs across court. Shot is no good. They're going to say it did not go off. Looked like a Frontier player blocked part of it, but they're going to say it was just a miss. And so Frontier will get the ball back. Dean runs right side. Bounce pass in the corner to Portier. Portier driving through. Gets a little daylight. She could not get it to fall, though. Second attempt, she gets fouled on the way up. And man, that's the second or third, maybe the fourth time the Frontiers run that play, and they've had a good look at the basket and just have not been able to follow through and get the bucket. But it's going to be the first foul on Taya Nolan, and two shots for Lisa Portier. First one, front of the iron, no good. She'll get one more. Second one rims out, no good. And a lane violation as Diaz came through, so going back the other way. 8-6 Frontier, 6:49 to go in the half. Carta Kelsa goes right side to Salvador. Ingrid throws it back to Aaron Clays. Clay's a real deep three. Misses. Not by much, though. Rebound pulled down by Diamond. Diamond. Right side to Munier. Munier's pass into Diaz. Partially blocked. Diaz gets it. Goes back up strong and hits. Helena Diaz was not going to be denied that time. And that makes it a four-point Frontier lead. 10-6, 6:12 to go. Salvador. Right side, Salvador lobs it in to Balkas. Balkas, put up shot, no good. Rebound pulled down by Marie Diamond of Frontier. Bounce pass to Diaz. Diaz, a jumper, top of the key. It does not go. Did everything but go in. Still going to be Frontier's ball, though. Checking out is Diaz. Checking back in is Lexa Boyden, I believe. And they throw it in. Dean. Diamond running through off the glass. Doesn't go. Still Frontier ball, though. So Frontier's getting their shots. A lot more looks than they had the other night against Turner's, but it's just not falling for them yet. Diamond inbounds. Dean now has it top of the key. Right side to Diamond. Diamond kicks it back to Ella. Ella back to Diamond. Diamond bounce pass in the paint to Boyden. Boyden loses control. Ball knocked loose. That's going to be a pushing foul. It's going to be on Frontier. So kind of an ugly exchange there. Timeout on the floor as Amherst wants to talk about it. That foul, by the way, was on Munier, her first, team six. 5:24 to go in the half. On the scoreboard, it's the Frontier Redhawks 10, the Amherst Hurricanes 6. This is Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Happy New Year, by the way, to those of us, those of you out there who are watching this broadcast. This is the last game of the 2016 calendar year, as the next time we're with you, it'll be a brand new 2017 year. And looking forward to the next couple of months of high school basketball. At this point, the chances of a second season, a playoff season, it's early, however, but both these teams need to get 10 wins to get into the playoffs. And Frontier boys struggling a bit right now, but anything can happen. A lot of time left, a lot of basketball still to be played for both these programs. But I like what I'm seeing from Frontier's girls tonight. They seem motivated, just haven't quite gotten the scoring touch yet. Clay's now with the ball. Rasmus half court, gets a block, a screen. Throws up a crazy underhand scoop shot, no good. Boyden the rebound. Up ahead to Diamond. Diamond gets knocked loose. And Nolan steals it back. Gives it to Lacey Backus. To Kalsa, very nearly traveled, didn't. Clay's now. In the corner it goes to Nolan. Nolan looking for someone to pass to. Feeds the paint to Backus. Battle for it, knocked loose. Stolen back by Diamond, or excuse me, from Le Portier. Actually, that's Ariana Walker just into the game. Boyden's turnaround shot in the paint is no good. Actually, never even got the shot off. It got blocked. Frontier will keep it with 29 seconds to go on the shot clock. Actually, I think I'm a fresh 30. Hickey will come off. And Torrey Speth is back into the game for Frontier. Inbounds to Ella Dean. Ella running one-hander in the lane. No good, but she got popped on the way up, so she will go to the line to shoot two shots. That's the second foul on Tan Noylan, sixth team foul on the Hurricanes. One more, and we're into a 1-1. Dean's first shot is no good. It's just not falling tonight. Second shot is good. She makes one of two. 4:31 to go in the half. It's now a 5-point lead for Frontier. 11-6. Both teams in the bonus right now. And a travel as Lacey Backus got the pass and shuffled her feet. A lot of traveling in this first half, mostly on the Amherst side of the ball, but Frontier's taking a couple of walks as well. Dean crosses half court. Ella. In the corner it goes to Walker. And shot no good. Rebound control by Frontier. Dean now. Left side to Diamond. Kick back out. Now Portier battling for it. They both hit the floor. That's going to be a travel on Frontier. As I said, that Munier had control of the ball and just held the floor. So Amherst will bring it back. Less than 4 minutes to go. Kalsa now. To Clays. To Salvador. Now a shot by Nolan is no good. Ella Dean the rebound. Dean left side to Diamond. Diamond spots up for three and hits it. Suddenly, it's an 8-point lead, largest so far for Frontier. Pass up ahead to Nolan. Nolan on the baseline to Salvador. Drives through and hits. Kick back to Diamond. Diamond with the ball now. Diamond drives through. Running one-hander off the glass is no good. Put back is no good by Boyden. She got fouled, and she will go to the line to shoot. Boyden's first shot is good. Checking into the game is Kate Hickey. Checking out of the game is Torrey Speth for Frontier. Second shot, no good. Ball knocked loose, Boyden gets the rebound. Fresh shot clock for Frontier. Dean, right side to Portier. Portier up, fakes, drives through, off the glass, too strong. Frontier gets the rebound. Dean now. Dean driving through, got a seam, lays it up, no good. And a putback, no good. And again, Boyden got a couple of shots at it, stayed with it, and draws the foul. So Alexa, who has 6 points, will go to the line to shoot a couple. Chance to make this a 9-point lead. That's three fouls, by the way, in Taya Nolan of Amherst. First shot by Boyden is good. She'll get one more. Diamond out, Hickey back in. As Marty Sanderson continues the quick substitutions, trying to make the most of that deep bench. Boyden second. Rims out, no good. Rebound pulled down by Amherst. Up ahead to Calsa. Right side to Salvador. Salvador spins away. Tight D by Frontier. Good job as they bottle up Salvador. Dean comes away with it. And Dean will pull it back, wait for the numbers. It's D by Frontier there. Right side to Hickey, to Ella Dean, top of the key. Dean left side to Portier. Now bullet pass inside to Boyden. Boyden kicks it back out to Hickey, to Dean. Now Munier took a little walk as she tried to outfake the Amherst player and again took an extra step. So good ball movement, but for naught. Boyden out, Helena Diaz back in for Frontier. Clays now with the ball. Clays, left side to Baumgartner. Baumgartner gets it back from Salvador. Now Clays for three. Spins out, no good. Caught some iron, but that's about it. Dean now with the outlet pass. 8-point Frontier lead, 16-8, 1:34 to go in the half. Dean, in a high post to Portier. Portier, looking for Munier on the baseline. Was it back out to Portier to Dean. Dean for three, and the ball gets hung up. Sometimes happens. Ball is stuck now. We have to get another ball to knock it loose, I think. Doesn't happen often, but happens occasionally. But that is as good as a turnover. And Amherst will take the ball back the other way. Uh-oh. Whoa, wait a minute. It's jammed in there pretty good. There we go. Should be Amherst ball, I think. The possession error actually was with Frontier, so it'll be Frontier's ball. Inbound to Dean. Dean gets knocked away. Still with, actually, like I say, it went off Ella, so it'll come back the other way for Amherst. 1:19 to go in the second quarter and the half. Lisa bringing it up. Top of the key to Balkas. And they feed the lane to Carter, but it's no good. Rebound pulled down by Frontier. Ella Dean, shot up no good. Diaz cleans up the board, no good. Another put back, no good. So Frontier's winning the battle on the boards. The problem is they're just not getting any second shots that are falling. And this is going to be a foul on Frontier. And because of the bonus, we're going to shoot one and one on the other end. Clays will go to the line. Actually, that's going to be Balkas to go to the line. The foul is actually on Portier. Her first, team's eighth. Balkas pounds the ball onto the floor. You're going to say no basket. I said there was a lane violation. So she made the shot, but it's not going to count because one of the Amherst players crashed the lane before it went through. 49 seconds to go in the half, 16-8. Frontier by eight. Bounce pass to Munier. Munier runs the baseline, reverse layup goes. Sarah Munier makes it a 10-point lead, largest for Frontier. 30 seconds left. Salvador now runs through, running hook shot from the top of the key is no good. Elena Diaz pulls down the rebound to Munier. Over to Ariana Walker, back to Ella Dean. Shot clock is off with 15 seconds left. In the corner to Portier. Portier drives through and gets fouled on the way through. And I think they're going to get Baumgartner for this one. We'll see. Nope, actually this is three fouls on Lacey Balkas. So foul trouble for the first time for an Amherst player. Lisa Portier at the line for Frontier. First shot is good. She'll get one more. Chance to make this a 12-point lead with this shot. And she makes the second one. 20-8. 9.8 seconds left in the game. Up ahead to Salvador. Salvador. Right side it goes to Carter Kalsa, and she got popped. And she really got hit hard, and I think she's definitely slow to get up. They're going to have to take a look at her, I think, because that was quite a collision she had with the Frontier player. Carter Kalsa is down, and that knee, which is already wrapped, looks like she may have tweaked her knee or her hamstring, possibly. It did not look like it felt too good. Help her up. She's their point guard. And again, I remind you, Amherst has seven players on their roster. So this could be a really serious loss for Amherst. As Carter Kalsa is off, Madison Lemire will take the court in place of the injured Kalsa. And Lemire will shoot. First shot, no good on the 1-1. Muni with the rebound, that'll do it for the half. We played one half of basketball from Goodell Gymnasium in South Deerfield. On the scoreboard, Frontier Redhawks with a commanding 20-8 lead over the Amherst Hurricanes. Second half action upcoming on Frontier Community Access Television. We're at the half at Goodnoe Gymnasium in South Deerfield. The Frontier Redhawks lead the Amherst Hurricanes by a count of 20-8. A interesting first half. The Frontier Redhawks came out much more aggressive than they did in their last contest against Turners. Jumped out to a 7-0 run, but then they were kind of snake bit for a while there, but they wind up with 20 points in the half. Leading scorer for the Redhawks is Lexa Boyden with 7 points, 3 points for Ella Dean, and 2 points each for Lisa Portier and Helena Diaz and Sarah Munier, and 4 points for Marie Diamond. For the Amherst Hurricanes, Erin Clays, Casey Baumgartner, Ingrid Salvador, and Toya Nolan, all with 2 points each, and a costly injury to finish the half as point guard Carter Kalsa of Amherst ended up colliding with a Frontier player on an offensive series and wound up with looked like a leg injury of some kind, left leg injury, knee or hamstring. Her return is questionable, and so this makes the numbers game very interesting for Amherst because they only had 7 players to start with on their roster. Now they have 6, assuming Kalsa doesn't return. Frontier leads 20-8 at the end of one half of play, and second half action is upcoming on Frontier Community Access Television. We're about to start the second half. Frontier leading Amherst 20-8. I don't think we're going to see any more of Carter Kalsa, the starting point guard for the Amherst Hurricanes, who was injured late moments of that first half. She got hung up and collided with a Frontier player, and she was coming out of the locker room hopping on one leg. So that's usually not a good sign that she's coming back into the game. So we'll see what Amherst does with 6 players on their roster, because they only had 7 coming in. They lost one, and it's going to be it could very well turn into a numbers game in terms of the ability of these kids to not become tired. And Frontier has a much deeper bench. They've got at least 2 full squads they can put out there. Amherst has 1 reserve now. with the injury to their point guard, Carter Kalsa. Inbounding in front of us is Aaron Clays to start the second half. Amherst moving left to right. Frontier moving right to left. A lob pass inside to Salvador. Salvador kicks it back outside. Nolan for three, air ball out of bounds. Frontier basketball. At the right line, just not enough juice on that one to potentially hit the bucket. Dean now bringing it up for Frontier. Ella, left side to Diamond. Diamond drives the right side, gets shut off on the baseline, back to Ella. Ella bounces it to Portier. Portier in the corner to Diamond. Diamond driving through, kicks it back to Dean. Dean, a running hook shot on the baseline, no good. Rebound pulled down by Nolan of Amherst. Clays drives through and a little bit of a scoop shot. Big collision in the lane. And it's going to be a blocking foul on Lisa Portier. And Aaron Clays will go to the line to shoot two shots. They actually gave that foul to Ella Dean, her first, team's first. First shot by Clays, no good. She will get one more. Second shot is good, so she makes one of two. Dean brings it up. Left side to Diamond. Bounce pass inside to Munier. Shot no good. Rebound pulled down, kept alive. Dean, left side to Portier. Portier cross court to Diamond. Diamond launches a deep three, misses, rebound. Portier goes back up, blocked, out of bounds, kick, reset. New shot clock for the Frontier Redhawks. Dean to inbound. Ella throws it out to Diamond. Diamond back to Ella. Ella spots up for three. Back iron, no good. Battle for the rebound, Dean gets it back. Nice hustle to Diamond. Diamond, left side to Dean, to Diamond. Right side to Portier. Portier, bounce passed to Diamond, to Ella Dean. Dean, cross court to Portier. Portier spins away, kicks it back out to Diamond. Diamond for three, no good. Frontier keeps it alive though, fresh shot clock. Diamond to Dean. Dean, a running hook shot gets blocked. And a foul on, it's gonna be going back the other way. I think Dean might have stepped on the baseline there, so Amherst will take it back. 6:05 to go in the third quarter. Clays, guarded by Dean. In the middle it goes to Nolan. Nolan, right side to Salvador. Salvador, off balance shot in the lane, no good. And Portier the rebound. Now Diamond brings it up. Diamond left side to Dean. Dean to Munier to Dean. Right side to Portier. Portier back to Dean. Diamond rather. Portier takes the shot. Hit the side of the iron, no good. Way off. Rebound control by Amherst. This is Ingrid Salvador. It goes left side to Clays. Clays drives through, gets fouled on the way up. And Aaron Clays will go to the line to shoot. And that's two fouls on Ella Dean. Clays, first shot is no good. Wholesale substitutions for the Frontier Redhawks. Diaz is in, Hickey is in, and Tori Speth is in. Clay's second shot is good. 20-10, Frontier by 10. Now a little bit of backcourt pressure by Amherst. Diamond now up ahead. The Diaz
muscles her way through, puts it up and in. Elena Diaz, but she decides to go to the basket. It's very tough to stop. 22-10. Now the backcourt pressure again, broken by Amherst. Clays gets a screen, gets hit on the way through. And that's going to be on Marie Diamond, and that might be three on her. It's definitely the third team foul on front. Yeah, it is three on Marie. Blocking foul, non-shooting. And they're going to get her out of there. Portier comes back in for Frontier. Hurricanes to inbound. Clays for three, no good. A rebound pulled down by Salvador, who goes up strong, and Ingrid gets herself a bucket. 22-12. 4:35 to go, third quarter. That's some more backcourt pressure. Portier and Dean, they cross the timeline. Hickey. Oh, it was tipped. It looked like a backcourt violation, but they're going to say he got tipped by the Amherst player. Portier, cross court to Hickey. Hickey up fakes. Back out to Ella. Dean. Bounce pass to Portier. Portier, a hook shot off the glass and in. Lisa Portier, very aggressive. Sky hook. And that meets the lead 12 again. 24-12. Clays now brings it up. And a poke from behind by Hickey. Kate Hickey with the poke to Ella Dean. Ella stops. Bounces it back. Diaz, a jumper. No good. Battle for the rebound. And Hickey hits the floor out of bounds. And it's going to be Amherst basketball. So a good little bit of defense there that turned into an opportunity, which did not fall for the Frontier Redhawks. Clays throws it in to Salvador. Ingrid now bounces it up ahead to Dacus. And now Madison Lemire with it. Salvador. Salvador tries to spin around, blocked up by Diaz. Ella Dean. What's the call here? It's going to be a foul on Ella. That's going to be three on her, I think. Yep. Fourth in the team. Possession situation. No foul so far yet on Amherst this half. Inbound pass to Balkas. Balkas put up shot, no good. Put back up, no good. By Nolan, rebound. Frontier, here come the Hawks. Whoa! The jump shot by Lisa Portier was a little bit aggressive, went over the top of the backboard. Don't see that very often. 3:16 to go in the third quarter, 24-12. Frontier with the lead. Salvador is running the point for Amherst. Ingrid drives through, scoop shot. She traveled as Elena Diaz bottled her up pretty good, along with Tori Speth, who just checked into the game. Hickey now up ahead to Portier, back to Dean as they break the press. Dean right side to Portier, back to Ella. Ella stops, cuts, gives it back to Hickey. Hickey jumper just inside the arc, no good. Rebound pulled down by Lemire. Outlet to Salvador. Salvador runs right side, spins through, nice move, lays it up and in. Nice play by Ingrid Salvador. That's a 24-14. More backcourt pressure, they break it. Up ahead, Speth to Diaz. Diaz on the baseline off the glass, got fouled on the way up. So Helena will go to the line for a couple. Helena Diaz, last year emerged as one of the more consistent players for Frontier. And this year, just an absolute force. Good basketball skills, good basketball intelligence, and very tough to move out of the paint. First shot is good. Munier is into the game for Frontier. Tori Speth will take a breather. Elena's second shot.
Box out, team.
And that one's good. She makes them both. Diaz has 6 points this game. She will step out. Timeout on the floor. We'll take the break. 2:23 to go in the third quarter. On the scoreboard, it's Frontier 26.
Amherst 14. This is Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television.
Tonight's 50-50. Last three numbers, 898.
So Amherst will inbound under their own basket. Coming back from the timeout. Aaron Clays to throw it in. To Ingrid Salvador. Running the point for the injured Carta Kelsa, who was hurt in the latter stages of that first half. Offside to Clays. Clays gets a screen, drives through, running one-hander on the baseline is good. Aaron Clays, nicely done. Dean crosses half court. Ella blocked for, went for a shot and got it blocked. But coming back to save it is Kate Hickey. Tried to feed the paint to Munier, out of bounds. It's going to be off Munier. It's going to be Amherst basketball. So the Hurricanes with a chance here to cut that lead back to single digits. Salvador spinning away from Dean. Now tries to get a screen, bounce pass back down low to Baumgartner. Baumgartner back out to Salvador. Salvador in the middle of Nolan. Nolan drives through, blocked out nice by Munier. Well defended by Munier. Did not get called for a foul. It's still going to be Amherst basketball with only 9 seconds left to shoot. Bound pass, turnaround jumper off the glass, no good. By Toya Nolan. Rebound controlled by Frontier Redhawks. Dean now, right side to Diamond. Diamond to Munier, down low. Hook shot through the lane by Boyden is no good. And possession arrow on the tie-up goes to Frontier. Minute 7 to go in the third quarter, 26-16, Frontier by 10. They will inbound under the basket. Diamond to throw it in. Gets it out to Dean. Ella to Courtier. Left side to Diamond for three, no good. Deep rebound comes back out to Salvador. Salvador, home run pass to Clays, but getting first to it is Diamond. And that was just a little too far ahead for Aaron. Driving through is Diamond, running one hand, scoop shot in the lane, no good. And rebound pulled down by Salvador. Ingrid now. Top of the key. Left side to Clays. Clays gets a screen for three. No good. Rebound comes down to Amherst. A running jumper in the lane by Salvador. No good. Put back no good, but she got fouled on the way up. And Ingrid Salvador will go to the line to shoot. With 24.4 seconds to go in quarter number three. Salvador's first shot is good. She'll get one more. She has 7 points in this game. Ella Dean checks out for a brief break. Salvador's second is good. She makes them both. 26-18. Frontier by 8. Portier, left side to Diamond.
Oh! Diamond just hit Baumgartner in the face with the ball, it looked like. Again, not intended, but Baumgartner, that's how close Baumgartner was to her. And we got a foul against Baumgartner. It's going to be her first. Team second. Diamond inbounds to Hickey. Kate in the middle. Quick shot by Portier, but she got fouled on the way up, so Lisa Portier will go to the line to shoot a couple of shots with 7.8 seconds to go in the third quarter. Portier's first one fronts the iron, no good. She'll get one more. And the second one is good. So Portier makes one of two. 27-18. Less than 7 seconds left. Salvador spinning away from Hickey. Throws up a wild shot at the buzzer. Almost made it, but it did not go. At the end of three quarters, on the scoreboard, it's Frontier 27, Amherst 18. This is Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Final quarter upcoming, Amherst inbound in front of us, trailing 27-18. Salvador now, slowly brings it up for Amherst. Ingrid pulls it back, left side to Clays. Clays for three, spins out, no good. Rebound pulled down by Lemire. Over to Nolan, and Salvador took a little bit of a walk as she was trying to drive to the right side. Hickey inbounds. Again, that little bit of a passive backcourt pressure. They break it up ahead to Boyden. Boyden, hook shot off the glass, no good. The rebound pulled down by Salvador. Ingrid runs it up for Amherst. To Nolan, back to Salvador. Top of the key jumper, no good, spins out. Rebound knocked loose, and it's controlled by Diamond of Frontier. Diamond kicks it left side to Hickey. Shot up, spins out. Tell you, Frontier just cannot buy a bucket, it seems. A lot of these shots that they're getting are relatively easy and they're just not falling. And in a different situation against a more high-powered offense, they'd have a problem. But tonight, Amherst has not been consistent either in terms of shooting. Salvador trying to spin away. The Clays, deep three, front of the iron, no good. That was a way out there. Hickey the rebound. And Kate brings it up. Left side to Diamond. Bounce pass to Munier. Top of the key jumper is no good. And a whistle and a foul. And that's going to be on Munier, I believe. So we'll go back the other way. One more and we're going to be in a shooting situation. That's the second foul on Sarah Munier tonight. 6:41 to go in the game. If Amherst is going to make a run for it, this would be the time to start. Salvador goes right side to Nolan. Excuse me, that is Lemire. Lemire to Clays. Clays trying to drive through. And a blocking foul. And
This should be, I believe, on Portier. Munier is out. And Portier will go to the bench. This is a 1-1. They have not posted how many fouls. That's actually three fouls on Lisa Portier. Clay's first is no good. He has the rebound. Outlet to Diamond. Diamond right side to Ella Dean. Back to Diamond. Left side to Hickey. Back to Diamond, back to Dean. Dean for three. Spins out, no good. Ball knocked out of bounds, and it's going to be Amherst basketball. Amherst inbound to Salvador. Salvador with the ball. Ingrid goes left side to Clays. Clays, three ball, no good. Diaz boxes out, gets the rebound. Out to Diamond. Diamond spins away. Top of the key. Speth back to Diamond. And ends up back in the hands of Hickey, back to Diamond. Diamond to Hickey, right wing. Diamond for three, or the Hickey for three, no good. Dean the rebound, Dean to Diamond. Bounce pass in the middle to Speth. Speth loses control, back out to Dean. Dean for three, spins out, no good. Diaz battles for the rebound, and still going to stay with Frontier as Helena went after, but it was last touched by Clays. 5:25 to go in the game, 27-18. Frontier with the lead in the ball. Dean. Right side to Hickey. Back to Dean. Left side to Diamond. Diamond to Dean. And right side to Hickey. Back out to Ella. Ella bounce passes to Speth. Back out to Hickey. Hickey launches for three. No good. Off the glass. Too strong. And a foul beneath the basket. It's going to be on Frontier. Actually, I'm sorry. It's going to be on Amherst. It's going to be on Madison Lemire. 10 on the floor. We'll take the break. 5:08 to go in the game. Frontier in control. They lead Amherst 27-18. This is Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Before we go any further, I want to wish a happy new year to anybody watching out there in TV land. A reminder, Frontier Community Access Television is having its annual open house and annual meeting on the 19th. The 19th of January from 4 to 7 p.m. at our studios in South Deerfield. Come by, have some appetizers, and say hello to the staff and all the people that make this the station rolled round and round, as they say. Diamond inbounds to Dean. Dean drives through. Jump shot partially blocked. Speth the rebound, back out to Dean. Dean to Hickey. Three-pointer by Diamond is no good. I don't think anybody, actually strike that, Ella Dean's hit 1-3. Other than that, Frontier has had no luck. And Diamond from the three-point line tonight. Clays for three. She hits that one. And suddenly the lead is cut to six. 4:30 to go in the game. Diamond runs right side. Bounce pass to Diaz. Diaz, a hook shot in the lane is good. And a quick timeout. We'll take the break as well. 4:21 to go in the game. On the scoreboard, it's Frontier 29, Amherst 21. This is Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. So off that basket by Helena Diaz. The Hurricanes will take the ball back out. 4:21 to go in the contest. And they trail by 8. Inbound to Salvador. Salvador bringing it up for Amherst. Ingrid tries to drive, gets a screen. Handed it off to Balkas, but it's stolen back. Oh, ball knocked loose, it ends up in the hands of Sarah Munier. And Frontier comes back the other way. Ella Dean, right side to Fortier. Back to Dean, left side to Diamond. Diamond goes cross court to Fortier. Fortier takes off on the baseline, layup no good. Battle for the rebound, possession arrow goes the way of the Red Hawks. Diamond inbound to Dean. Dean up fakes. Goes right side to Fortier. Fortier to Diamond. Diamond feeds the paint. Back out to Dean. Dean for 3, front of the iron, no good. Diamond gets the rebound, fresh shot clock. To Ella Dean. Top of the key to Munier, shot no good. Battle for the rebound again. This time the possession arrow favors the Amherst Hurricanes. 3:23 to go in the game. Amherst once again will try to trim this lead. They have trailed throughout this game. Salvador, right side to Nolan. Except for one-point lead early in the first quarter, they have trailed for most of this game. The pass ended up hitting Diamond in the back of the head. And Ella Dean bounces it right side to Fortier. Fortier hands to Diamond. Right side to Fortier. To Munier, tie up, stays with Frontier. 15 seconds on the shot clock, though. 2:48 to go on the game clock. This is going to be a low-scoring contest, no matter how it ends up, comparatively speaking. Diaz, oh, she is all alone on the baseline. The pass went through her hands. Tough break. She was already thinking layup. Now a kick and a reset, which actually is a break for Frontiers. They only had 14 seconds to shoot. Diamond to inbound. Bounce pass in to Munier. Munier tries to feed the paint to Fortier, and it's stolen back by Balkas. Out to Salvador. Ingrid. A little floater through the lane. No good. Battle for the rebound as Balkas went in there with Fortier. And it looks like Lacey Balkas will go to the line to shoot. And if that is, in fact, on Fortier, that, I believe, is 4 on her. We'll see what they post. It is 4. Balka's first shot is no good for another 1-1. Rebound pulled down by Fortier. Diamond now. Right side to Fortier. Fortier trying to lob it in. Gets it back out to Dean, top of the key. Ella backs it out. Trying to work. Goes back to Diamond. Diamond, top of the key in three-point land. Drives through, dishes it into the corner. And Munier did a double dribble. That pass was just not quite clean enough for Sarah to spot up and shoot. And we have another timeout on the floor. We'll take the break. 2:09 to go in the game on the scoreboard. Still Frontier 29 and Amherst 21. This is Red Hawk Basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Amherst will inbound another basket with 2:09 to go in the game, 29-21. Frontier by 8. Ingrid Salvador running the point. Crosses the timeline. And on top of the key, it goes to Nolan. Nolan drives through, running hook shot, and she's fouled on the way up. So Taya Neuland will shoot a couple here. That is the 9th team foul this half on Frontier. That's the 3rd foul on Sarah Munier. First shot is no good. She'll get one more. Second shot, front of the iron, no good. Rebound pulled down by Portier. Over to Dean. Less than 2 minutes to go in the game. Ella, left side to Diamond. Diamond, running jumper in the lane, spins out, no good. Ball knocked loose, out of bounds, and it's gonna be off Frontier. So Amherst will take it out. Clay's inbounds to Salvador. Ingrid brings it up. Ingrid right side to Lemire. Lemire's shot is good. So Maddie Lemire with her first bucket of the game. That lead is suddenly cut to 5. Diamond now crosses half court. Diamond. Right side. Now a whistle. And this is going to be Frontier's ball. As they've got a fresh 30. Dean, left side to Diamond. Diamond in the corner. Inside to Boyden. Now the pass is intended for Lemire. Kick, and it's going to be going back the other way as the pass ended up in the feet of Sarah Munier. So 1:02 to go. 5 points. Salvador, right side to Clays. Clays, back in the middle. Back to Salvador, right side. Salvador, shut off to Balkas. Now kind of a crazy shot by Nolan is pulled down by Frontier. Red Hawks going to win this one. As they foul Ella Dean to stop the clock. And they still, although that's not a shooting situation because they still are under the bonus. So they have 3 more fouls to give, or 2 more fouls to give before they, there's another one. That will stop the clock. So one more and they'll be in the bonus. They throw it back into Ella Dean. And Dean's going to run up the left side, and then she gets fouled. Now we're into the 1-1. So that took some precious seconds off the clock for Amherst. And Ella Dean will go to the line and will shoot a 1-1 with 27.1 seconds left in the game. First shot is no good. But Boyden got the rebound. Turnaround jumper on the baseline, and that will probably be the icing on the old cake. Timeout Amherst will take the break. 20.6 seconds left on the scoreboard. It's Frontier 31, Amherst 23. This is Red Hawk Basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. So the final 20.6 seconds left to go here. Frontier leads by 8. They're going to go to 2-2 on the season. Barring something bizarre. Pass and bounce to Clays. Clays runs it up. Loses control. Ends up in the hands of the center. And now throwing it through Salvador. Shot up no good. Put back no good. Salvador's follow is no good. Salvador puts it back up again, and that one falls, and that's going to do it. So that will do it. The final score, Frontier Redhawks 31, the Amherst Hurricanes 25. We'll come back and wrap it up on Frontier Community Access Television. Well, the Frontier Redhawks got their second win of the season as they defeat the Amherst Hurricanes by a count of 31-25. Frontier, I think, was a little more aggressive offensively than they have been, and it certainly paid off. They jumped out to a 7-0 run and kind of got a little bit flat there in the first quarter, but then they had a relatively consistent, although low-scoring pace. A lot of shots that were taken that were missed, but sometimes that happens in the early season. But they come away with a 31-25 win. Leading scorer for the Frontier Redhawks, Lexa Boyden, with 9 points. 6 each for Marie Diamond and Helena Diaz. 5 for Lisa Portier, 3 for Ella Dean, and 3 for Sarah Munier. For the Amherst Hurricanes, leading scorer was Ingrid Salvador with 10 points. Aaron Clays had 9, and 4 each for Carta Klasa, who left the game with an injury, and Taya Nolan, 4 points, and 2 for Madison Lemire. The final score, 31-25. That'll do it for our coverage from Goodnow Gymnasium in Deerfield. Thanks for watching, and once again, the final. Frontier Redhawk girls beat the Amherst Hurricanes by a count of 31-25. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you next time on Redhawk Basketball.